Hello and welcome to the race 16, I think it was, at the Indian track here, but international circuit, I think it's pronounced. We're going to do 30 laps here, as we can see the track, and I'm with Stirling Decay today, so.
Hello.
And we won't be having any qualifying comparison since we only had one qualifying with the full lap, so, and the fast lap he did, so it wasn't really worth us just watching the one car, so.
Yeah, and sadly I was missing Conrad Jonas in the commentary box today.
No, he was probably out doing some smelly Frenchman business.
Yeah.
As we see here, Stirling is in fifth position at the start.
Yeah, the guys, the qualifying was a real roundup for all the guys.
I think a lot of people didn't even set times. I think a couple of people only just made the time, so.
Yeah, also we're seeing that some of the slower guys actually are up in front. But as we got four lives, five lives, and the start is gone, and looks like Sinclair is getting a decent start.
Yeah, and then
start.
Of course Son of Mo retired because he had an injury, so he couldn't play this race.
Sadly.
Ferrari is on the inside of Stirling, pushes him kind of wide.
That is
That looked weird. It looked like Ferrari came sideways into him. The Ferrari again. And they're pushed wide by something. It's Yava pushing him wide, I think.
Yeah, it looks like we're going to get a replay of that.
We have the McLaren on him, which Weissguy coming on the side of Stirling, but Stirling is faster since he's on red, and I don't think Weissguy usually does that so much. So.
I don't think that
Weissguy... Ive goes out here. Weissguy is still on the side. The question is what will happen now. Weissguy coming in. Stirling jumps on the back of Weissguy. What's he doing?
That was a dark start, if you can say that.
I think Weissguy is throttling down just to let Ivy pass, since he obviously had a bit of contact with him because Stirling hit him, so.
Yeah, that was that could be a horrific incident if that was going to happen in real time. Ivy,
where did he go?
That was attacked by Stirling now.
I think actually Weissguy is just defending now because I think Stirling cut the track. Well, there he just cut it again. I think Weissguy is just saying, I know you're faster, but don't push me.
Yeah, I think that also was a bit of aggressive from seeing the case. So
we're going to have a replay of the race once again. Weissguy, you can see he started in ninth.
Yeah, but that was... I think
Yava and Silent Armstrong in front of him. Yeah. What is it?
Position for Weissguy, is that actually not his best qualifying so far in the league?
I think it was, but he didn't even qualify because he knew there were only 10 cars and he was probably going to be last anyway, so he might as well just start on complete fresh tires.
Yeah, that was.
But then Stig didn't make to set a lap either, so well then
Ivy
breaks early.
And so that is why Sisinko goes going wide.
It looks like the Ferrari breaks kind of early, so Weissguy just can't react in time and hits him.
That looks like Yavanna stay.
He dive bombed into the Ferrari, so he pushed into Stirling, who pushed into Armstrong.
It really doesn't look like the Yavanna stay was turning, if you were looking that way. His car, it was just going straight up.
Weissguy trying to get some clean air instead of being behind everyone, and he locks up a bit and hits into Ivy.
Yeah, and of course,
and then Stirling comes flying again.
Yeah, you won my pass.
That was
That was crazy.
That was
Let's take the spot, by the way.
Lucky for Ivy.
Okay, here we can see Weissguy giving the spot back to Ivy.
Yeah, but it was very lucky that Ivy is in K and side corner got that.
Someone could have easily crashed there and lost the entire race on just that one incident. And there we see again Ivy goes. I don't know where he's going. I think he just goes into gravel for some reason. And there we see Stirling's aggressive move on the inside of the curb, and Weissguy just pushing a bit back and Stirling cutting him off here. Weissguy then already took the wrong line, but...
Yeah, but if you look that, there are no contact on a Sin K screen at through the last corner.
No, I know, but there is Weiss, but that's the usual lag differences, as we saw, and... I think it was another video where in my video, I were a car length ahead of Armstrong, and in his video, I were right behind him.
At Korea, but I don't think I've seen that, but, is he Armstrong
He's
trying
making
to
move on the side of Weissguy, but will he make it done?
Yeah, he will less.
Yeah, but
so
we can see here, because Weissguy has the outer line, he's a bit faster here, and can he get hit? Oh no, he's not in front.
And they both went
into gravel.
Going into gravel,
and their stick goes past them.
Yeah. So,
it's the Stirling replay where he jumps onto Weissguy.
That is just,
We can see here, Weissguy being pushed into Ivy, being pushed off the track, and... I think Weissguy just gives the spot back to be sure. And here we are with Isaac Musing on lap 4, and I think he's going to the pit.
It looks like the pit window has opened already at lap 4. That is very early, but as we know, tire wear on this track is extremely high, and the guys will fight with tire wear till the end. And so yeah,
I think especially single tires are always, it's mostly the front left tire getting just killed.
Yeah, also Asmussen got held up for what was that, 2.5 seconds around there, but he's also onto the harder compound now. So
He can make a longer stint now. The question is how many pit stops he's gonna do.
Looks like he struggled a little bit with cold tires.
Yeah, no, of course he did.
Yeah, of course, but still, I've never seen that before. Then
we are at lap 4 at Stelling, chasing after Java. I don't think either of them have pitted yet, so.
No, it doesn't look like that across the Taiwan.
Yeah, I changed side once again. Why is he doing a slalom? This isn't slalom. It's not the Winter Olympics, this.
No, I don't think we have joined Sochi's yet. Next year.
It's first in 2014 that we're going to drive in Russia, in Sochi, where they also have the Winter Olympics, so. Java is a bit too early with the slalom, so.
You watch it too early, yeah, that is clearly. That's. I think that is a rule saying you only allowed to change line 2 times.
You're allowed to change when you're defending. Oh, here we see Armstrong going to pits, probably going to the harder compound as well. It's Matthews, sorry.
Yeah, that is Matthews, yeah.
Crazy,
I'm tired now.
With Pivka.
Anyways, yeah, you're only allowed to change lane once, but of course, if you're in front and there is no one behind you, just on your side, you can go to the correct line of
Itara, over the pit stop.
Into the corner as well.
Yeah, of course, as he's going on to the harder compound too.
I think most people were doing starting on the soft and then going to the harder. I think Armstrong perhaps will start on the hard, but I don't remember.
Yeah, Armstrong have starting on a bit odd tire.
He often starts on the hard.
Don't know why.
It does yellow.
But it's looks
I don't know why either, because it doesn't seem he can make longer stints in the starters either. So.
As we are seeing Case trying to hunt down Jovan Asdagen, and he is doing this
slalom once again.
Wow.
I think we should, in the next race we have a sort of a straight as well, we should put cast that he has to slalom through. That would be kind of fun.
Yeah, I think I don't think this is allowed, and I think look into by the stewards and seeing what else happened. Maybe we'll get some confirmation on that in the video, or not in the video, but in this commentary on nuts.
You see Stelling here attacking Java, trying to get past him, pushing him a bit.
Yeah.
It clearly looks to me that like Stelling just a way faster, but Java is blocking really nice at the moment, at least here on the corners he's blocking nice, so.
You
see Stelling pushing here, going a bit wide through the corners again here. I think tire wear is beginning to take its toll on these two drivers.
Yeah, and he's cutting again. He's really struggling with the tires and a lot of those here. You can see that on the steer. I'm a bit confused there sometimes. But and it's look nice.
I think they go to pit.
Yeah, and that is your nice day too. So
Stelling going a bit short and wide at the same time.
The guys have really struggled with taking that pit entrance. I think
it is a very difficult pit entry because I think it's very slippery out there. So you have to go so fucking slow to even get in there, right?
Yeah, there is no grip whatsoever because there's no heat there. It's just
retarded.
Of course, there's 10 cars going around there, but it's so
it's just slippery. It's just slippery the surface over there. You have no traction whatsoever.
Exactly, and he's ghosting. Wow.
Yeah, well, I think it's because the computer just realized that Weiss guy is behind him, so still he might fuck up for as usual. So Weiss guy would hit him. So
that is correct. But will Syndicate do the same slalom as Jovan Asdagen doing to trying to get the up for us?
Well, now we just have to get the traction right, but
yeah,
it looks like he got it now. But now he changed lane once.
Yeah, once. No, he's
just staying in order not to annoy Weiss guy in the back.
Yeah.
And then, he goes into the left side to take the corner on the right side. Right way in, whatever you should call it.
Yeah, it looks like Syndicate struggling with the grip and to get the tires down to the track and then...
I think it's just the usual, of course the tires are cold, they might be starting to get warm now, but then again, going from the soft to the hard compound, soft to medium, that's kind of difficult because you just have to get adjusted to how they react to the track, so...
Yeah, definitely. If you also are looking at the same case, front tires are overheating a lot, and Prospect 2 is a very hot
Just this sector. It's this stupid ass sector that just overheats everything.
Such a sight.
It can't make the move done. I think Java has the right lane, so...
Yeah, he's going for the outside.
Can he go in the inside and then faster? No. Java still blocks very nicely, but now he has the DRS, but is it not enough?
Maybe we can get him on the straight, but I don't think...
It looks like Java has more acceleration than the Force India does.
It really looks like that he's also running with a bit lower downforce than Scott is.
It might be that as well.
Of course, every guys are running with a different setup, so...
Logically.
Yeah, some guys may be teaming up and giving setups, but we don't know.
As we see, Java just doing the slalom once again, and now Stillinger says, "I don't want to do that anymore."
Yeah, he don't want to destroy his tires by doing that when going fast and things like that. So, and that is nearly counting.
And he took the cone once again. This time he didn't land on anyone.
Thank God for that. Wow, thank God he didn't that. Didn't do that. Yeah, thanks for breaking me.
Retarded out.
Oh yeah, it's I see going a bit.
Can he go on the inside now?
I think he can.
But the question is if he's gonna go wide now and Java can come on his inside again.
Going a little wide.
He just cuts the corner, so Java can't get in there.
Yeah, I think he's defending very heavily right now, and
everyone else does a bit of corner cut, but then everyone does it.
Yeah,
it's almost you can't race his track unless you're corner cutting it just a bit.
Yeah, of course.
Otherwise, you'll be completely last.
Exactly, and of course the guys are not.
Well, the vice guy on lap 7, and he's going for the pit. I think it's his first pit stop.
Yeah, we can also see his left tire is completely gone. His driving is good. We can definitely see that.
We can see there is no grip in that area, and we can see Ivy just going past him.
Yeah, it also looks like it was a very bumpy entrance to the guy, so maybe that will upset the balance in the car when they're going into it. Or is this just me?
I don't know. I didn't notice that.
Oh well.
I just drive in there when I'm.
Try to notice when we are seeing another pit stop, maybe. If the guys are going to do that. I think definitely a 2 or 3 stop will be there. We're seeing Sinke.
And Lap 8 being chased by Java. But the question is if Java have enough downforce and enough speed and enough momentum to get past Stilling?
Yeah, of course, he's doing the right to defend and then going in. Oh, locking up.
And he goes wide there. The question is now Java come, and there he is, just going right by.
Yeah, that is. I think Steve K is right now just sitting in his inside his helmet, just screaming, "Why did I do that?"
And once again, Stilling is—you can see way faster. And he punts Java a bit because Java breaks a bit early in those corners.
I think that's this showing that Steve K is running with a bit more higher downforce than Asse doing it, so he gets the advantage in sector 2.
It also makes perfect sense because Stilling is way faster than Java in sector 2, but in the other sectors, Java seems to be a bit faster.
Yeah,
especially on the straights. When they're coming to corner, Stilling is way faster than him.
Yeah.
Even here, we can see Stilling is breaking later than Java, and Java has the better line. So.
Yeah. So definitely higher downforce worked in sector 2, but of course in straight line he will struggle, and we have seen that.
It's DK Cousin. I think it's his first pit stop as well on lap 8.
You think that is the.
I think he's the last guy to go to pits.
There's another person Armstrong going into pit. Also, if you look. Looking down in the minimap.
Yeah, it might be. Yeah, I think it's Armstrong. Yeah.
Can we see a ripple going past? No, he's of course back in the.
Yeah, he's not getting out in front.
Yeah, I don't know. So lap 8 was the last pit stop done.
At least for the first round, I think.
Yeah, for the first pit stop.
But the question is, I think perhaps some of the other guys will start to getting into the pits again soon because they are fighting a lot. So.
Yes, you're seeing Armstrong.
And here we're seeing Armstrong. Again, it's the same pit stop.
Yeah, really struggling with the car. Also seeing the option tires was going as long that as the prime was. So that was a bit nice to see that, or not nice, but sadly to see that
His gamble didn't really pay off because he went the harder tires, but Stig drove as long as he did on the soft compound, and Weisgaard drove one lap shorter than he did. So
yeah, and
it didn't really pay off to start on the hard tires.
Yeah, I'd be really trying to attack.
Of course, Ivy has the warmer tires, but again, he's on the slower compound, but he has warmer tires.
Yeah, I think he got DS too.
I just think Armstrong have way lower downforce than Ivy has.
It's look like they're running similar downforce on the world now.
It's just, Armstrong still can maintain a car with who has DRS on him.
Yeah.
And then Armstrong will have to have way lower downforce than Ivy.
Yeah. Well, this is a very interesting race to watch right now, and hopefully everyone will finish and no crash whatsoever.
Oh, whoa!
That was
where did that Ferrari go? That's the second time I've been that took a straight weird line.
That and
it's amusing going to the pits.
Yeah,
and we're on lap 14 now. I can see.
Was it just me, or was the Ferrari turning into the wall?
Yeah, it looked like he hit the wall. I think he had.
I really hope we can get a replay of that, or just some kind of.
I think the only way we can get it confirmed is by looking at the table afterwards. I don't know if that was a Ferrari coming into the pits then.
I think we
can probably see it in the how people are, where they are in the grid. Because he were at what, 6th or 7th place when it happened?
There was 7th battling for 6th, and yeah, we're seeing a replay from Matthews right now. So at lap 14, I think, yeah, that is correct, yeah. But how can that Ferrari, tire, why is he already pitting now?
I think perhaps he's in 2nd place and Ice Amusing just pitted as well, so I think he's just following Ice Amusing at the moment.
Oh, wow.
That's probably it. But I think the Ferrari might have touched the curb when he accelerated a bit too much, over revving, and then it just spun right into the wall.
Yeah, but I've never seen that curb doing that to people's car.
But I think perhaps a lot of people aren't really accelerating that much, but so he might have been a bit too aggressive on the throttle. But here we see Stelling, and yeah, I think he's going to the pits again. Yeah, he is.
Yeah, he is. That is
a bit wide as usual.
Yeah, of course, there's no grip in that pit lane whatsoever. Going on to the prime tires again. Looks like he's just going for the prime tires, I think.
I think he's doing a free stopper, so he might be doing option prime prime option.
Yeah, but it's
It would seem logical because at the moment he has done around what 10 laps on the
About
options on the prime tires, and then he taking another set of primes, then he can go to lap 25 and then the option for the last 5.
Yeah, I think that is probably correct what he will do.
Armstrong going wide.
Yeah, really. He are really struggling with the grip, but of course his tire are completely gone, I think. So we can see the tires when they took the rear tire off. So completely gone, no grip whatsoever on that tire. So of course he's paying for a new fresh of rubber. It was seeing DK Cousin.
DK hunting down Yara and Winters.
Oh,
and he spins.
Whoa, that was wow.
How did he even do? It's also kind of sad that the only wall within 1,000 miles is directly where his car chose to go off.
Sorry, but I've never seen a person do that. Of course, you got the DRS as you saw, so. But sad we didn't.
Oh, I see him going to the pits for the. First of all, a new front wing, but I think new tires as well.
Yeah,
he is getting the new tires on, and he's going to the soft compound now.
It's rare to see Stick make a mistake, if you get that.
Yeah, well, it's the Stick's DK Carson, it's not the real Stick, you know.
Of course, but
it's one of his many cousins. Yes, apparently have a lot of cousins.
Yeah, the Italian one, the friends, the Smith friends,
the American, his teenage cousin, and so on and so forth.
Yeah, but how can he?
I think he forgot to change his gear, so I think he was just over revving and then it just spun out.
Yeah,
you can see Vice guy. What? I think he was fooling a bit around there. It looked like.
That didn't. Oh, whoa! Kind of.
Stick behind him.
Yeah, and Vaiskov of course taking the defensive line, so
so he has the right to go to the left once more to take inside on the corner.
Yeah, so of course Vaiskov again doing the correct, so and Stick goes and go for the inside, can
and Vaiskov locks up a bit. I don't think Vaiskov can get the speed now.
I didn't think that it was costing Vaiskov anything, so
I think Vaiskov is going to the pits again.
Yeah, that is some.
Where did he corner cut there?
I don't know. I just think the game wants to give him a corner cut.
Apparently. I don't know.
Well, this.
Sometimes the rule system is just retarded.
Yeah, hopefully that will be fixed till the next game.
That's what we said in 2012 as well, so.
Yeah.
And they just made it even worse.
Yeah. Something has been fixed and some things have just gone worse. So I will not consider that anymore.
Armstrong hunting down Yaba once again.
Yeah, maybe Armstrong will get the same problem as Dominic Kay got with the insane lane change, I think. Maybe we'll see. Or will he just go past?
I don't really think there isn't much of a choice to change lanes right here, so. And Yaba goes a bit wide there.
It looks like he was, yeah, I see, and also Armstrong going to standard mix again, so he was going to lean through that sector, saving some fuel.
Yeah, I think a lot of people is doing that because they know they are slow anyway, so there's no reason to just bleed fuel through that then entire sector.
Yeah, and then maybe going into a ridge at the straight, I think that
is exactly. Well, I actually think Armstrong, when he's in the straight lines, he usually goes to lean the way I see him. At least when he has the DRS, because then I think he just knows he's faster, so there's no reason to leave fuel along with when he also has the DRS open. So.
Of course, and then just trying to force a person ahead of him to make a mistake.
Exactly.
This is very interesting, as you're seeing one change and...
Yep, just one change, and now he's...
And then, of course,
the last one to get into the right side, which is allowed. A bit early, but it's allowed.
I think that...
He almost crashed there. And took the other
That was very close to hit that thingy. Wow. Close.
But the question is now, will he be able to get close enough to the other again to try and overtake him in this sector?
Really, I don't think he can. Of course, he's going to lean, so he will... Jonas Day will probably maintain a little gap of maybe 500 tons, so... It is, as seems to hey, going into the pit. No, he's not.
What was that Ferrari doing there?
Clearly, the Ferrari have
I think
some.
It was Broadway, and here we have the replay actually.
Wow.
I think he has spun in the pit entry.
Wow, that
just shows how crappy the pit entry is. And
that's
an alternative route to the pit as well.
Yeah, we have seen some oil drives doing that in the higher splits doing that, and
they got penalized everyone. So
they got penalized.
But I think they did it several times. I think this was Armstrong. He was just trying to watch what Yava was gonna do, and then Yava went to pits, and then Armstrong knew he couldn't defend if Yava had fresh tires, so he just thought he would go to pits as well. I think.
Yeah, but again, he maybe need to take that decision way before that.
No, because his decision depends on what Yava does, so he can't really take the decision. But here we see Stick going to the pit again in lap 22. But what tire will it take?
As we're getting down to the last 7 laps, so
it's another set of the soft tires.
Yeah, well, good pissed up by the Lotus people. It looks like really they are having a good round. Of course, Ice Racing is leading race. If you were looking at that when we got the pit stop, we saw that Ice Racing was leading the race. And I think that Matthews.
Yeah, I think Mateus is in second, and here we can see Vice Guy is actually at the moment. I think he's being lapped by someone. I would think it was Ice Racing, perhaps.
Yeah, it is
Ice Racing. And Vice Guy just going to the left straight away to give Ice Racing the space he needs, but...
But it's...
It seems Ice Racing just wants to slipstream Vice Guy for a bit here to try and get some speed, and Vice Guy breaks a bit early. Well,
it's
late, actually.
Yeah, it's...
And Ice Racing, of course, goes past him.
Yeah, of course, but it looked like that he was running with a higher downforce.
Yeah, well, it doesn't look like the Lotus is very fast in straight line speed, but we can see now... What's going on? Because I think Vice Guy is going to get the DRS of Ice Music now, and he does.
Okay, can you tell me one thing? Why does he use his curse? Because he, of course, he can overtake him, but he needs the place going back.
Yeah, well, I actually think it's just I think he used his curse on all his curse on the straight every lap. So, but as we just saw here, Vice Guy were driving with the DRS open, 310 kilometers an hour when he had to brake in order not to go ahead of Ice Music once again. So,
yeah, that's clear. Sure, he got.
But I actually think he's always using his downforce. His curse when he is on the straight lines, the longest straight line in a race like this, because where the fuck on this stupid track would you else use it? You can just make
oh, see,
very short races.
Up! Whoa! That is
in the gravel.
That is just
Winters will get up to him now.
His tires is completely gone.
And I think he could have been done a couple more laps. They don't look that weird to me. I think he's just over aggressive at the moment, trying to catch up with Mateus.
Yeah, of course, that he's at 26 seconds in front of him, ahead of him.
Behind
so.
Of him. Stelling is 26 seconds behind of Mateus.
Yeah, and Mateus is ahead of him, so.
Yeah.
It's depending on how you say it, so fuck it.
Oh, I'm saying the right way.
And of course, he's going down to 50.
And there, who's that? That's Broadway
that
coming down.
Of course, we saw that there was Broadway, of course. Turning the wrong way at the pit lane.
Mateus going to the pit here at lap 24.
So that's of course he's going.
I think
to
he's trying to undercut Ice Music at the moment, actually. Because I don't think Ice Music has been to the pit for the last time.
Yeah, but I think also that
doing a two-stop.
Yeah, I think that I think he was also trying to start the hunt at Ivy now, but yeah, we have got pit stop by
Ivy. I would have chased Ivy. Ivy's worse in last, I think.
Broadway.
Yeah, we made that as well, but
they are both from Poland, so no offense to them. Whatsoever.
Your mom's friend.
Of course, I think that the same.
Here we are with Isomusing at the moment. One lap later, and he's going to the piss as well.
Yeah, and the car following him. No, it's doesn't.
No. Right. I think actually it's Vice Guy over unlapping himself once again.
Yeah, Vice Guy was he shows some pace in this race. I need to say he's showing some real good pace. Even that he's not the fastest driver in this split. So yeah.
I just think his problem is his stupid controller. He can't seem to get the soft throttle, soft braking, and soft steering right. So yeah, he might as well just use a keyboard, which is fucking difficult without tracking control. And here we are with Armstrong once again hunting Jabba still. Here in lap 25, but I think they started lap 20, so it's 5 laps into that chase.
Yeah, but it's.
And you see Jabba lagging a bit.
Yeah, of course. He's from the USA, so. Oh, lagging up there. Oh, that is a very brave move done, but it's really looks
can
like
he,
that.
But can he get it done until this next corner? I think they're side by side now, so.
And he's of course going into lean. I think that he will let him.
I think Jabba is getting the spot, yeah, there he goes.
Yeah, he got this. Yeah, he got the.
He got the right line, the inside line, so yeah. Armstrong couldn't do anything.
Yeah.
I think now it looks like Jarvis way faster. Yeah, I don't know when he pitted in this race, so I don't know if his tires are more fresh than Armstrong's.
Also, what compound was he on? Was that the right stripe or that's
I didn't really notice that.
You can maybe see it up here. It looks like the yellow stripe.
Yeah, I would have said red stripe if we had an O. It's the yellow, I think. I would have said red stripe. It looked like red even though we didn't have any red tires. So.
Sorry, I still said it.
But I think it is.
That is yellow.
It is yellow. Definitely yellow. Yeah.
Yellow confirmed.
That's the soft tires. So yeah, they are the same compound. But the question is, whose tires are the freshest?
Yeah, I think.
I actually think Armstrong's is the oldest because I think he pitted. When we saw him pit last time, I think Jabba continued on the track. So.
We can also see that his tires are starting to grain a little bit on his front left and of course right. So yeah. And completely that Armstrong cannot come up to a nice end this race. Of course he's trying, but I still think he'll going past him at the straight.
But the question is if he can make a move on the inside here at some point and hope Jabba maybe goes wide because Jabba is too aggressively defending, so he breaks a bit too late.
Yeah, I just think that Armstrong so far just.
I think he's waiting for Jabba to make a mistake. Honestly,
yeah,
to be honest.
He's doing it by himself.
He makes a mistake himself, yeah. Once again, him lap 27, 28 now.
28.
Stupid ass counter.
Yeah, he's need to.
Still hunting Jabba for the next place.
Yeah, and all 2 laps left, so. This has been a very interesting race to watch, and I really enjoyed it, so.
I think we're still having quite some battle here going on. Because I think Jabba is just constantly seeing that Armstrong right in his mirror, and oh, can Armstrong make the move here?
That is very laggy.
But outside.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, well, of course he's lagging quite a bit.
Well, that is. Oh, he is going
and
wide.
He's going wide. Of course he is.
And that makes the move done by Armstrong. So I think that Armstrong within is 6 now. I don't think that Jonasje will get back.
And here we are with Armstrong once again. I think Jabba is up to him once again. I actually think Jabba's tires is way fresher than Armstrong since he can catch up with him after a huge mistake like that.
It's really look like that, and of course you can see him gain 5th, so I think that is. Yeah.
Well, I don't dare to say anything. This track can fuck you up in just a single second. If you miss one corner, you miss the rest of the lap, so.
Yeah, and
I'm going so easily fuck up. But Armstrong is really trying to defend here. I think he took some. Made a bit of a gap down to Jabba at the moment. I think it's half a second now.
Yeah, it's half a second now, so.
But can he maintain it for the last lap as well?
Oh, he will get the DS at the start finish race, so maybe that can change some.
No, exactly, but that depends on how well Armstrong gets out of the corner.
His left tire was logging a little bit up, and you can see his tire is completely gone. Completely there is no grip left.
But then again, you can say, why would he go to the pit now? It just would make no sense.
Yeah, of course, he's just trying to stay on
he's
the edge.
He's just trying to defend it for the rest of this lap, so.
He's not, he's trying to not fall off. And He's really... Oh, that is... No, that is...
Almost goes wide, then.
That is...
Can Jabba come on the inside?
Yeah, yes, he
can.
Is,
and Jabba will get the DRS as well, so...
And the laggy.
And there you can see his wings opens. And now Armstrong is just behind him, slipstreaming to... No, apparently he don't want to slipstream Jabba.
That is beginning strange.
To run out of fuel as well, we can see.
Yeah,
I think everyone is starting to run out of fuel, but... Because I think a lot of people have been doing a lot of grid driving through this race. So.
But even that, we saw that he was
a bit of contact, I think, here.
Yeah, there is a lot of contact there. Definitely contact.
Actually, it looks like this sector just fucks it up for Jabba all the time. Because this is the only sector where I clearly can see Armstrong is way faster than him.
Yeah, maybe he can get the move done now. Yes.
Can he come in inside?
Inside?
Yes.
No.
Oh, Jabba goes wide.
Oh, that was a very wide line. And he's playing inside
he
line, that is an illegal.
Got a penalty for that.
I'm not sure about that.
Get a penalty, but I think you don't just get a penalty just for nothing. I would say if it was because you also overtook Jabba at the same time, it would have given him an illegal overtake to hand it back. So I think he have corner cut it quite a bit.
I'm not sure.
And there goes over the line. So as we can see here, in first place was Ice Amusing, followed by Mateos, Winters, Broadway, Stelling, Jabba and Armstrong, Steak DK, Vice Guy, Ivy and Son of More. As we can see here, Armstrong got his, well, we can't see it here, but he got plus 10 seconds, so that's why Jabba is in front of him.
Yeah, but I'm not sure about Armstrong's penalty.
I don't know either, but anyways, I think Ice Musing is quite strong in the lead now in the champions with, what is it?
Yeah,
it's third win and the fourth win in a row.
See it now.
Yeah, we can see you have 150 points, with 14 down to Winters in second, 27 down to Stelling. That means Stelling has to get one first place and a ninth place just in order to be at the same level of points, which means Isaac can't get any points. So I think Isaac, unless he fucks up now, I think he can have won the championship.
Yeah, he has done an amazing comeback. But we will see you guys at Abu Dhabi next week.
Yep.